A simple video, only a vlog about how to test an IF amplifier. And it all regards my project that I'm working on, the long wave radio. And then the super heterodyne radio, the super heterodyne principle. So I had to make an IF amplifier that's here. The schematic is on YouTube in two videos. Here is the, say, audio amplifier, first stage. In between we have, of course, say, the classical AM detector made with a germanium diode. And after that, germanium diode. So here a capacitor, separation capacitor. Here a separation capacitor and here a resistor and a capacitor of 47 nanofarad. This could be between 100 nanofarad, so 0.1 microfarad, and also here 100 nanofarad, also 0.1 microfarad. And in such a situation, because we have here two separation capacitors, we can give that as germanium diode, by the way, germanium forward voltage. And you can derive that out of a potentiometer. Say it's 1 megaohm, that's a good value. And here for protection, a 1K resistor, 1K. And this goes to the voltage supply that is in general 12 volt. So anyway, kind of side pass about all what I wanted to tell, but anyway, this shows a good way of AM radio detection. The germanium diode has to have, say, a barrier voltage between approximately 0.3 and 0.5 or 0.6 volt. Also explained in many other videos. Anyway, the IF amplifier again, the end amplifier again, the audio amplifier. When you make such a radio, it's a very, very good idea to use an audio amplifier that can handle approximately 1 watt or 2 watts. And of course, in many mini radios of the past, you don't see that, say, high output level in terms of audio. But anyway, it will surely help to get a better detection of radio signals, and especially weak radio signals. Of course, this is a video made for radio amateurs. Anyway, here is the local oscillator. It's now connected to the positive lead via this brown wire. And there are a few, say, phenomenon that I want to show when you make such a radio. At first, the oscillation problem. Such a radio on a wooden board, piece of wood with brass nails, etc., etc., is in a kind of way sensitive for oscillations. That doesn't have to happen. When you cover the underside of the wooden board with tin plate, not with aluminium but tin plate, so steel plate, very thin, etc., and then connect that steel plate here to the minus of the radio. Anyway, local oscillator is now connected to the power supply lead, Let's see what happens. Let's see whether we can see a kind of leakage of the local oscillator to the power supply lead. And I directly say that that does not have to be a problem. So here is the the noise that you hear. That noise is coming out of the IF amplifier. So when I touch here the base of the first transistor in the IF amplifier, that has an enormous effect, and that's completely healthy. That's the most important thing that you have to hear, you must hear, when the whole circuit that you make in an IF amplifier could be made with a field effect transistor or a few field effect transistors or bipolar transistors, that it does work. On the other hand, when the amplification, and that regards all kinds of electronic circuits, when the amplification is too high, or the phase of the signal is shifted in, say, not a good way, you get oscillations. And I will surely demonstrate it here. This is the end amplifier now. It's the audio amplifier here. And when we lift up that audio, it's a grounded emitter stage, so we can set the amplification. There are many videos on my YouTube channel where I have told about it. When we lift the amplification too much up, the circuit starts to oscillate. And on the scope, perhaps interesting to see how that oscillation looks like. So a bad situation, of course. A radio doesn't have to oscillate, it's not an oscillator, but it's a radio. So lift the end amplification back to a normal level, and also say important to tell, the hum that you hear now is hum that is caused by the fact that the circuit, the LC circuit, by the way, in that oscillation mode takes a too high current. When a too high current is taken out of a power supply, so not the current where it was made for, you hear hum. So here we set the whole circuit to a proper maximum amplification. Very important. You hear the noise, and noise makes happy. That's say true in electronic terms, but also in many other ways. When there is noise, there is life. Could also be related to corona. That's a controversial issue, but anyway. So I don't want to dig too deep in such a issue, but anyway, noise means life. Put the noise back now. Well, let's see what happens when we change the value of this potentiometer and that potentiometer, and this potentiometer, by the way, sets the voltage to the field effect transistor. And that means that you can, say, change the effect of the field effect transistor, the BF254A, from a, say, resistance amplifier to an active amplifier. Perhaps I can demonstrate it now. So now the amplification of the field effect resistor stops. I have to take my hand. And now you hear noise, and that's good. And there is a certain bandwidth on that potentiometer where the amplification stops, etc. etc. There, the circuit is also on my YouTube channel. Here is the, say, final IF stage. You could also change the with the potentiometer. The amplification of the final IF stage, you can surely hear that it's here very good. Here it drops down, and here it's more or less nothing. Anyway, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. Well, more or less all to tell. Again, interesting to see what happens when we touch the base of the mixer transistor. You hear the noise lift up. I will set my scope to the maximum amplification. Touch the base of the mixer transistor. That surely has an effect. I, of course, can get to a, say, very deep evaluation, but that's not the aim of this video. At least I wanted to show that when you have made an IF amplifier and you don't hear nothing, that's a bad situation. So you have to hear something when you connect your homebrew audio, sorry, not audio, but IF, intermediate frequency amplifier for a super heterodyne radio, to a detector circuit that's here, or to a end amplifier, and study everything with the oscilloscope. The oscilloscope is, say, the best device that I can advise. Use it always, you get a real good insight when we are talking about radios, and especially radios, but also audio. The oscilloscope is in many cases the only device that can help you working on electronics.